Welcome to a lesson on the brute force algorithm in order to find the lowest cost Hamiltonian circuit. To review, a Hamiltonian circuit is a circuit that visits every vertex once with no repeats. Being a circuit, it must start and end at the same vertex. To answer the question of how to find the lowest cost Hamiltonian circuit, we will consider some possible approaches. The first option that might come to mind is to just try all the different circuits. And this is the brute force algorithm, also known as the exhaustive search. Step one, we'll list all possible Hamiltonian circuits. Two, we'll find the length of each circuit by adding the edge weights. And then three, we'll select the circuit with minimal total weight. So while this algorithm does seem very basic, mathematicians have not been able to prove that another method exists or prove that one doesn't exist to find the lowest cost Hamiltonian circuit. Let's take a look at an example. We want to apply the brute force algorithm to find the lowest cost Hamiltonian circuit. It doesn't matter which vertex we begin at, but to keep things organized, let's begin at vertex A, and then we'll list all the Hamiltonian circuits beginning with A and then B. So if we go from A to B, notice how we have two choices. We can go from B to E or B to C. Let's go to C. From here, we still have two choices. We can go from C to E or C to D. Let's go to D. So from here, we have to go to E and then back to A. So we have ABC, DEA. Now for the next circuit, let's go from A to B, back to C. But now instead of going to D, let's go to E. So we have A, B, C, E, D, A. Again, we have A, B, C, E, D, A. We have one more starting with A, B. Go from A to B. But now instead of going to C, let's go to E. So we have A, B, E. Now from here, it might look like we have two choices, but we only have one. If we go to D next and then to C, we cannot get back to A without using a vertex more than once. So from E, we have to go to C, then to D, then to A. So again, we have A, B, E, C, D, A. Let's go ahead and record these circuits in a table, which we see here. And now we'll continue, but now we'll start with vertex A and then vertex D. The way we're listing these, we are going to have some duplications in the circuits, but I think it's the best way to go because it's difficult to recognize the duplicates by just listing out the possible Hamiltonian circuits. So we'll start with A and then D. Let's go to C. From C, again, we have two choices. We can go to E or B. Let's go to B, and then E, and then A. So we have A, D, C, B, E, A. And we'll go ahead and find these weights at the very end. Next, let's go back to C. So A, D, C. And now instead of going to B, let's go to E. So we have A, D, C, E, B, A. We have one more starting with A and then D. We can go from A to D, and then instead of going to C, we'll go to E. And again, from here, we only have one choice. We can't go to B, because if we go from B to C, we can't get back to A without using a vertex twice. So A, D, E, and then C, B, A. So A, D, E, C, B, A. So again, notice how this circuit here, A, D, E, C, B, A, is really the same circuit as the second circuit here in reverse order, A, B, C, E, D, A. But we can more easily identify this by looking at the weights when we finish. Now that we've done all the A, B's and A, D's, We'll now take a look at the circuits, starting with A and then E. So if we start at A and then go to E, we might think we have three choices, but we really don't. If we go to C, we can't visit B and D and get back to A without using a vertex twice. So from A to E, we have to go to either B or D. Let's go to B first. So we have AEB, C, D, A. Leaving us with the last Hamiltonian circuit, which should be from A to E, to D, to C, to B, to A. Now that we've found all the Hamiltonian circuits, and again, even though there is repetition here, we'll now find the weights and find the smallest total weight. We won't go through all these. Let's take a look at the first one, though. From A to B, that would be 5, plus from B to C, that would be 7. From C to D is 6. From D to E is 1. And from E to A is 2. So we have 5 plus 7 plus 6 plus 1 plus 2, that's 21. And now we would do the same for the remaining Hamiltonian circuits, which to save some time I've already done. Notice how several of the circuits have the same weight, which makes it easier to identify the duplicate circuits. For example, notice the circuits with a total weight of 19 are duplicates. ABC EDA is the same circuit in reverse order as ADE CBA. And the same thing is true for the two circuits with a total weight of 21, the first and last circuit, as well as the two circuits with a total weight of 20, and with the two circuits with a weight of 22. And we're looking for the lowest cost Hamiltonian circuit, which we can see would have a total weight of 19. This circuit and this circuit, which are duplicate circuits. We can't assume they're duplicate circuits just because they have the same weight. We can verify this by reversing the order. ABC EDA is equivalent to ADE CBA. So the lowest cost Hamiltonian circuit can be given either of these two ways. I do also want to mention that if we didn't start with vertex A, we would have an equivalent circuit that would be listed differently. For example, if we started with vertex B, we can list the same Hamiltonian circuit as BC EDA, but then back to B. So we should recognize that this would be an equivalent circuit as the one that we gave here below. And of course, we can also reverse the order as BAD ECB. I hope you found this lesson helpful.